So let's proceed with these three questions first. Now we have to find the equivalent resistance between the points A and B. Do remember that all the connecting wires are resistanceless, and hence any point on a connecting wire is of same potential. So the each and every point on a connecting wire is equipotential. That means you can take them as a single point. So this is one thing you should know. So the best part is you name the points, and if you name the points, then you can proceed with the solution very easily. How so? All the points on a connecting wire, as I said, are equipotential. So if this is the question, so what I can do is A and B are given. So this is a wire, equipotential point, so this will also be A. If this is A, this point will also be A. If this is A, this point will also be A. So all the points on a connecting wire being equipotential, we can replace them by a single point. And once you do that, your question becomes very simple to answer. How? We have got only two points in this circuit. What are they? A and B. Simply mark the points AB and connect all the resistors given. What are the resistances? So you have got 1, 2, 3 and 4 resistances between the points A and B. And each resistance, as you can see, has the same value R, and you have got 4 parallel resistances. So what I can say is 1 by RAB will be equal to 1 by R added 4 times, which clearly means that the equivalent resistance between A and B will be R by 4. You saw how simple it is. Now moving on to our second question. In this question, again we have points which have been marked. Let us try to see, is there any series or parallel combination or not. Well, you can see that between C and D there are two resistances RR, and there is a single resistance. So this figure can be redrawn as RR. This is AB, C and D. So we have got a series combination of R and R between C and D, because we are interested in finding resistance between A and B. So R and R in series becomes 2R, and this is R. So this figure now can again be simplified as only 3 resistors left, R. This is R. And between C and D, 2R and R are in parallel. So as I said, R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. If you use that, you get this as 2R by R1 plus R2. So this becomes 2R by 3. So if this is 2R by 3, then what is the equivalent resistance between A and B? Well, we have got 3 resistors in series between A and B. So R plus 2R by 3 plus R, which becomes 8R by 3. So here you saw series and parallel combination applied one after the other gives a value of 8R by 3 between A and B. Now moving on to our third question. In this case, the figure appears to be same as that in the second question, but with a slight difference. They have given a wire. Whenever a wire is given, that means it is a short circuit, which indicates that C and D will be of same potential. So if C and D becomes of same potential, then you can never have resistance between a single point. You need at least two different points to have some resistance, because if C and D become single point, then this resistance R and R are of no use, because they do not contribute anywhere to the current flowing from A to B. So C and D become of same potential. So what you will do is this diagram can be redrawn as R and R. So the entire resistance gets eliminated, because potential difference or resistance, I am repeating for the third time, should be between two different points, and C and D are of same potential because they are connected to the ends of a connecting wire. So what is the value of RAB in this case? This becomes 2R. Now, once you have understood this, in the further problems, I will not be drawing this resistor in this shape. I will simply show it by wires, but that does not mean that they are connecting wires. I will be putting the value of resistance also. So kindly understand that. Once these three questions are clear, let us move to the next question. In every question, you need to keep in mind that first of all, mark each and every point in the circuit by some name. Then see which of the points are equipotential. If the points are equipotential, then you get lesser number of points left in the circuit. Now you can solve them very easily. For example, the fourth question, we have got a square type network with some resistances marked. All the values may be anything, but just for the sake of convenience I am taking them to be similar, same. You can solve it by giving different values of resistances also. The method should be same. Now what to do here? We have to find resistance between A and B. So let's see. What I can say again is, if this is B, then this should also be B, connecting wire. This is connecting wire B, this will be connecting wire B. If this all are B, this point will also be B. Now let's similarly see for the point A. If this is A, we can say this is A. If this is A, then this will also be A. If this is A, then this will also be A. Do we have any extra point left over here? Let's see. If you move from here to here, we get another point which is neither A nor B. Why so? Because there are resistances placed in between. So they are not equipotential. So if not equipotential hardly matters, name it C. Now if you name the point as C, then you can see that there is another connecting wire which will cause the potential of this point to be same as that of C. So I can name it as a C also. So how many points are there in the circuit? In this circuit, which otherwise appears complicated, there are only three points, and you have to find potential the equivalent resistances between two of them, that is A and B. So let's proceed. Simply marking the points A and B, and there is an intermediate point C. Now make all the connections in between them. How many resistors are present between A and C? First of all, let's see. 1, 2. So two resistors between A and C, I draw like this, RR. How many resistors are there in between C and B? Let's see. C and B, R, C and B, R, C and B, R. So there are three resistances. So I will mark 1, 2 and 3, R each. And is there any resistance between A and B? Let's see. Between A and B, there is a resistance R, and apart from that, I am not seeing any other resistance. So there is one more resistance between A and B, which has a value R. Now this can be very easily solved. Okay, once you have read parallel, we saw that if resistances are equal, so 1 by R plus 1 by R plus 1 by R, if being added n times, I can say simply that if R n resistances, equal resistances are added in parallel, then equivalent resistance will be R by n. And if you add in series, it will become nr. Why so? In series, all the resistances get added. So R plus R plus R n times becomes nr. And if you add the reciprocals n times, you get n by R. So taking the reciprocal again, resistance becomes R by n. So that thing should be clear to you. So I'll be redrawing the circuit as between A and B, R and R in parallel becomes R by 2, plus in series with these three are in parallel, R R parallel, R by 2, R R R parallel, R by 3, and the combination will be in series, so we'll add them, and there is one more resistance which is R. Now R by 2 plus R by 3, what will be the value? 5R by 6. And since 5R by 6 and R are in parallel again, so I can write from here, RAB will be equal to this into this divided by this plus this. So R into 5R by 6 divided by R plus 5R by 6. So this becomes 5R upon 11. So the equivalent resistance between the points obtained is 5R by 11. So this is the case fourth. Now let's move on to the next question. The fifth question the points A and B have been marked. Suppose this time I am taking different values. Now over here, let me tell you that if a symbol like this has been made, that means these two wires are not touching each other, but they are, there is a type of bridge formed between them, so they are not touching each other, you will not consider them as a single point. Got it? Now in this case, to find RAB, we will proceed with the same method. What is that? First of all, you need to mark the equipotential points. So if this is A, this is B, what I can say from here is, if this is A, this will also be A, because there is a wire, connecting wire. And if this is B, then this also becomes B. Now how many different points are you seeing in this particular question? Well, I can see only two points, A and B. Can you see any other junction? I don't think so. So you have got a simplified figure for this A and B. Let's see what are the resistances. In the topmost branch between A and B, R and R are in series. So if R and R are in series, they will sum up to 2R. In the bottommost branch, A and B, ,2R and 3R are in series, this becomes 5R. Then there is one more branch, A to B, where we have 4R and R in series. So 4R and R in series becomes 5R. And there is one more branch, A to B, R plus 2R in series becomes 3R. So what is the value of equivalent resistance between A and B? Well, you have got four resistances in parallel. So in order to find four resistances in parallel, what I will do is 1 by RAB is equals to 1 by 2R plus 1 by 5R plus 1 by 3R plus 1 by 5R. So this value, 1 by RAB, taking the LCM, 5 3s are 15, 2s are 30, and 15 plus 6, 21, plus 10, 31, plus 6, 37. This means RAB is equal to 30R divided by 37. So this is the value of equivalent resistance in this particular electrical circuit. So is it clear to you? In all such questions, what was the main thing to be noted is that, first of all, give names to each and every junction or point in the circuit. Once you do that, try to check for equipotential points. Equipotential points having same potential are those in which there is a connection made through a connecting wire, and in such cases, what we can do is we can replace the two different points as a single point, by a single point. And then when the number of points get reduced, simply draw a rough diagram and indicate all the resistances in between them. And after that, if series and parallel combinations are present in there, then you can apply the respective formula to get the answer. I hope it is clear to you. Kindly note them down.